Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, our respected guest speaker and respected panelists and attendees. I welcome you all on behalf of AMP for today's web talk on a pathway to careers for 2025 and beyond by our speaker today, Mr. Atik Sheikh. Now we are going to have AMP introduction, inshallah. Dear brothers, as you can see on the screen, we are about to discuss about AMP presentation. AMP stands for Association of Muslim Professionals. Alhamdulillah, it's a journey started in 2007 till date. As you all see, AMP had got registered in India, USA, UK, and Australia as a non-profit organization. AMP had completed 13 years of serving our community in the field of education, employment, and empowerment. Our vision is to positively impact 10 million people by the year 2030. You can see AMP mission and vision as well here, to empower the underprivileged for the greater benefit of the society in general and national as a whole. You can see AMP vision. Next slide, please. To know about any organization, to know the achievements is very important. You can see the achievements of AMP since started from 2007. AMP had some projects like school development programs called SDPs. With these programs, AMP had conducted 2,800 skill development lectures. To this SDLs, 800 plus schools got connected. With this, 281,000 students got benefited, and 110 teachers training programs had conducted. Next project is employment assistant cell. Under this, we had conducted 360 plus job fairs and job drives. 21,000 candidates are employed through Employment Assistant Cell, AMP. 220 employability trainings have been conducted, and 17,000 plus degree students benefited. Our AMP, another project was a school scholarship and self-employment. With this, 800 plus higher education scholarship had been provided, and 860 plus often educations for these students also had provided scholarships. 425 plus had been benefited, and the AMP Resource Center careers, we have 660 plus career counselors. Under these, 2,500 plus students counseled. Like this, we have been doing many programs, alhamdulillah. We're being awarded the teachers under this, under the program of award and partnerships. Next slide, please. After this pandemic, this coronavirus, AMP had introduced three programs launched, like IndiaZakat.com, the IndianMentors.com, and AMPOwerJobs.com. In the time of Ramadan, IndianZakat.com program had been launched to handle the donations. The people who are not able to donate physically, they can utilize this platform, IndianZakat.com. With this, they had donate. The causes many. Second, the IndianMentors.com. Khalil bhai, you're saying something? Yeah, about AMP reach on ground. MashaAllah, AMP had 140 plus active chapters, and it got spread in 16 countries and 26 states in India. With these 6,000 plus active members have been participated, and 125,000 online presence is there. Next slide, please. You can reach us on to join AMP, visit www.ampindia.org/joinAMP. Other details are there, phone number, contact details and all. Request if anyone wants to join, please. Thank you. Jazakallah khair. Over to you, Sister Hippa.
Assalamu alaikum. Now I would like to introduce our eminent orator, Mr. Atik Sheikh. Mr. Atik Sheikh is currently working as a business partner CMO at Personality Matixx and is also a managing partner at Technotex India Private Limited. Mr. Sheikh is a textile engineer and is an alumni of IIM Calcutta, where he has completed APMP. Mr. Sheikh has 19 years of gigantic work experience in international and domestic merchandising sourcing, cross-functional team management, and mentoring. He has worked with many renowned and acclaimed organizations like Bombay Dyeing, Wellspun, and Textrade International. He has worked for very top clientele like IKEA, Tesco, Walmart, ASDA, Kohl's, BBB. These organizations are present geographically and is spread across Europe, US, UK, and rest of the world. I might have not justified with the introduction, but the speaker will speak for himself as and when he takes his session. With that, I would like to invite Mr. Atik Sheikh to take over the session and enlighten the audience with his cognizance. Welcome, Mr. Atik Sheikh. Please take over.
Yeah. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you very much, Hiba. Thank you very much for the AMP team. And thanks a lot for giving me an opportunity to present myself. So to continue with the presentation, I will share my screen. Okay, fine. I'll continue with the presentation. It's regarding a pathways to the career for 2025 and beyond. So this session will be important for who are looking for a start of a career or mid of a career and who see the technology, how it is driving, so they can plan themselves for the next level of a career. So about me, I mean, something, most of the things Hiba has already covered. So this is the roadmap of myself. I basically belong to the place called Nagpur. And now I am settled in Mumbai. So my basic qualification is a textile engineering graduate and then pursued MBA from IIM and then worked for the organizations like Bombay Dyeing, Wellspun and Textrade and worked for the retailers like Walmart, Carrefour, IKEA and all. So this session is an interactive session where we need a participation and we will be talking about technology shift, how it is happening, how world is shaping nowadays, major job and industry business, and how this will impact to the future. Key professional skills that will be required for 2030 careers. And identifying the personality strength means what understood is based on if somebody is working on his personality strength, it drives to the passion to the job and there is no monotony on his work. Another one is career path based on the interest group that, I mean, we may not be covering in this session, handling hurdles and career mentoring. So coming back to now this slide takes back to us to the invention that happened in last 100 years. Here it is a radio which is invented in 1901 and then 1903 is the airplane is invented. Now if we see today's scenario, there is an artificial intelligence, internet of things, mobile, electric car and global warming, sustainability. Now one unavoided issue is coming out, come out, that is COVID-19. And that shaped the world and that changed the world a lot. So in these 100 years, there is a lot of change. If we imagine what could be the life earlier, so it will help us to imagine next 50 years, what could be the situation. For example, if we wanted to understand what could be the communication era in 1900, I mean, how approximately time taken to send a message to the customer or a person sitting in US. So it was approximately, wild guess could be around 15 days or 25 days in earlier period. And travel time may be around 6 months. It's my wild guess. And if somebody want to participate, they can put it in a chat box. Exactly how much time it took to reach to the US. And that is the case. So now we can imagine what could be the situation. Currently, if we see, if we wanted to transfer any message, WhatsApp is there and it hardly takes a minute to reach information from destination A to destination B, whichever could be the place in the world. So these complete change shift has arisen and given an acumen to the persons that what could be the near future. I'll discuss about what is the 21st century innovations are already in a pipeline. These are innovations, around 21 innovations that are listed in USA Today magazine's latest. So 3D printing is a major innovation which is considered as an breakthrough. This 3D, if we wanted to know about more about the 3D printing, 3D printing is a convergence of cheaper manufacturing methods and open source softwares. However, has led to the revolution of 3D printing in recent years. Today, the technology is being used in the production of everything from lower cost car parts to the bridges and less painful ballets, sleepers, etc. It is considered as tough. So this 3D printing is considered as a coming era of discussion, and it is already available nowadays. Now, second, I would like to discuss about the blockchain. This is the simplest explanation of the blockchain, is that it is an incorruptible way to record the transactions between parties, a shared digital ledger, and the parties can only add, and that is transparent to all members of the peer-to-peer network where the blockchain is logged and stored. Now, if we are completely discussing about the cryptocurrency nowadays, this technology was first developed in 2008 in a Bitcoin, the first decentralized cryptocurrency, but it has since been adopted by the financial sector, and it is considered as a complete revolutionary technology in our coming years. Again, I will talk about capsule endoscopy. This is something that is already in place. This is advancement in light emitting electrodes, image sensors, and optical designs in the 90s. This works in such a way that as the capsules traverse the digestive system, it has an internal camera in it. Doctors can examine the gastrointestinal system in a far less intrusive manner. Capsule endoscopy can be used to identify source of internal problems, internal bleeding, inflammation of the bowel, ulcers, and cancerous tumors. So this is something which I wanted to highlight, how the technology is going around and what could be the life near future. Now, in terms of automation and digitalization, the industry is divided into the four parts. First one is digital life. It is considered as around more than $1,000 billion industry as per US statistics, and this digital life, digital brain, and digital work. This is divided into the three parts, which I will be covering in the next slide. Second is nutrition and wellness and athleisure. This, considering the COVID situation now, everybody is more worried about health and whatever the nutrients they are consuming. Third one is apparel and life play from home. Now this COVID has given an chance to everything from home. So the industries which are coming in this situation are mostly doing whatever the work to be done from home. Another is luxury products and experimental luxury wealth managements. So these are the things which I'm just exploring, and I'm sharing some details about it. When we see how this digital world will work around, so there is a one quadrant that is listed is digital work, where there will be the working on a data centers, artificial intelligence, big data analytics, blockchain, robotics, process automation, everything will be there. So whatever the names listed on a slide, these are the major players in this era working on it. Then if we consider about the digital brain, it talks about the complete industry 4.0 automation. I mean, all will be driven by robots, no human touch, and all these working processes, everything will be defined accordingly. So the whatever the companies listed on a digital brain header, these will be the target companies if somebody want to target a job in this case. But in the further slides, I will discuss about what are the skills required and what is the, I mean, basic normally for this consideration, basic qualification would be normal analytics and computer engineering, electronics and digitals. These will be the basic qualification required in this case. When we go for the digital life platform, there are the Amazon is the major player that we all know nowadays is working, means everything we can do from home. This situation, if we consider around few years back, this is something which is not considered that it could be happen in near future. Now these are the 8 areas where most of the things are going around. That is, first one is artificial intelligence, internet of things. These are completely 100 trillion impact, which is considered in US economy. So these all situations are mostly the job generator areas in this case. This is the report I have from the future job reports of 2018 World Economic Forum. This gives us a light which jobs are in a declining phase and which are in an emerging phase. So when we focus about our community, our skill set, mostly our skill sets are into the currently we consider as a declining phase. So when we consider a skill set of our community, we need a complete major shift, mindset shift, so that we can upgrade into the upper roles by acquiring a proper qualification, and then everything will be considered for a person who is expecting a career for the future growth. So this, I will read out this 10 emerging jobs, that is data analyst and scientist, AI engineer, machine learning specialist. So many courses are there in the market available for this to acquire these skills. Some is sales and marketing professionals. The sales and marketing professional will be very much required by considering an additional skill of their analytics and how they manage people's and collaborative work environment. Digital transformation specialist, new technology specialist, organizational development specialist. These are the specialists which these persons needs a proper organizational skills, people management skills, and they can collaborate with the teams, involve themselves in a role so that everybody will come in place and discuss the ideas. Now I will talk about 10 top declining jobs in the job markets. That is, one is data entry clerk. Most of these works will be taken care by the computers and automatically everything will be coming place. we are already observing this situation. For example, when we are booking an airline's ticket, when we go back around 15 to 20 years, we were going to the airport and we were taking a boarding pass. Now, airline industries has an option that we can take the print at home. So whatever the data entry clerks, they were operating that job already, we are seeing that it is in a decline phase. Second is accounting, bookkeeping and payroll clerks. Completely this operation is getting automated. Accountants and auditors. These accountants and auditors jobs is mostly be considered as done by robots or automatic systems. So this is another an area of concern. I'll be considering about what are the 12 jobs that are mostly considered as a changer in future by 2030. First one I come across is organ creator. Organ creator is something like we need a technology where artificial organs will be created. This will save a human life. This will save a human life and will be used for any person who is in need. So the basic recruiters are searching for the candidates with a background in molecular biology, tissue engineering or biomedical engineering to perform this organ creator job. A major studies are going on in this from the New Zealand and European countries. Second one is augmented reality builder. Starting with the notions developed in Total Recall, the AR journey builders will be a most important job that is considered. The position will demand a film school degree as well as an experience with massively multiplayer online role-playing game. Cognizant says an exceptional knowledge of familiarity and leading head mounting display movement is the requirement for this case. Third one I will say about biofilm installer. Biofilm installer is a something like a very different kind of a role. It's a collection of microbial cells attached to the wet surface, which are icky, sticky and tricky. They are literally slim pond scum and the source of 80% of microbial infections. But they are also remarkable tool for a sewage treatment, oil spill cleanup. So by coating certain surface in the bathroom and a kitchen of homes, they will become key tools for environmental friendly. So they will take away all microbial infection into that chip and everything. I will discuss one or two because this, if you know, wanted to more a team about this, these are all listed on a LinkedIn. So we, if somebody wants to refer in a detail, it can go and check more about it. I wanted to discuss about digital currency advisor. With the soaring interest in the use of cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, Litecoin and Ether, digital currency exposure will be more. So CST says that specialized in digital currency will require a person who has a knowledge of it and work on it accordingly. Drone traffic optimizer is one more area that is considered in future cases. So I will go to the next slide. If somebody wants to have more information about this, can visit to the LinkedIn page. Now, when we talk about what was the life in earlier stages and what could be the life in future. So this is Alvin Toffler has a quote, "The literate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn and relearn." This means there are so many things that we need to unlearn. If somebody is thinking that they do not want to go with the digital payment and something, and it has some challenges over there. So this is something that we'll have to unlearn and adopt with the technology. Now, another thing when we as a community, if we find out what could be the our situation, if we say whatever the technology is coming and we will prepare ourselves based on our luck, but that is not a case. Luck is what happens when a preparation meets an opportunity. That means his proverb says we'll have to prepare ourselves that whatever the opportunities are arriving or coming in the future, we should be ready to adopt the technology and should be ready on it. So now, based on this situation, what as a personality matrix and as industry is doing it, majorly it is working on a skill set. So upgradation of a skills, what are first the finding of the skills required to perform the activity and future goals. So when we define a skill as an ability to do an activity or a job well, especially because you have practices. Here the emphasis is word on a practice. If we see, consider a Generation Z, I mean, they are quite resistant about practicing the things. There is a FOMO situation where they need everything instantly. So this could be an area of concern either for a community or for a generation that we need to acquire new skills and that too in a faster way. Now, about a personality matrix that we are doing in this case, I would like to share something. Personality matrix aims at enabling people to excel by providing self-efficacy in terms of individuals' cognitive and behavioral capabilities. What we wanted to say in this case, if a child is born, he has certain capabilities and the capabilities goes on growing once he goes into primitive stage and adolescent stage. Now, in this case, his core of the brain is developed and he is very good in certain skills and he is little bit imperfect or I would say not good in other skill. For example, somebody will be very good in sports or singing and somebody will be a very good in analytics. If I take an example of Sachin Tendulkar, he was a very good batsman in this case and he identified that he has this skill. So he has practiced himself a lot and he excel in his field. So now in this case, how we can identify our skills? So we have a methodology in this case, how we at the age identify and work on the what is our core. So there is a proper systematic approach is there. And so many persons, so many companies are working in this case. So that is again a thing which need to be considered. Now, what is industry concern nowadays? Every industry is facing about limited skill availability. Now, in order to achieve the global competitiveness and availability of productive and skilled manpower is very important. At present, the education and training infrastructure is not geared up to the meet and the demand of the skilled labor. This is a concern that is raised by many industries. Even our Prime Minister is addressing about this and he's majorly focusing on upskilling of the youth and the generation. Now, again, we find out that investment in improving the skills and productivity of the workforce by both private industry and as well as the government in genuine partnership is missing. That means whatever coming out in this case is not up to the mark. By the way, other countries are doing up like China or European countries, what they are doing in this case. In India, we find little bit a gap in this case. So I would like to share a story in this case. I mean, this is about in 2010, a company in US, they were having their workforce in Europe, US and Asian countries. So this is the situation of around 2010 or prior era. They carried out some course online to upgrade the skills of their workflow so that they give an assignment to the persons who will qualify these tests. So there was a course of around 4 months something, and this course was online conducted. Post that, they have an evaluation system which was online, and the condition is who has already adopted and taken the course, they can refer the books and solve themselves the answers, whatever the questions online have been asked. So the participation in this case were from US students, European students, and Asian country students, especially India and Pakistan's and Bangladesh and everything. So this was an 1 hour test worldwide. There was no observer, but the timeline was completely 1 hour for all the geography of the world. What happens? They carried out the test and the result was astonishing. I mean, US peoples who were there, they do not qualify for the test. Even Europeans were not qualified for the test. But the Asians, that is Indians and Pakistanis, were the best performers in this case. So they thought maybe they have the right skill set to understand. And they asked to perform the job given based on the test. But what happened when the job is assigned to them, they do not perform it what have been taught them earlier. Then they whosoever was organizing the test, they gone to the analysis of failure meant what had happened. So what they understand from this Asians means Asians countries persons who are the participants who were participate in this case, they were not referring the books, but whatever the answers they were given is in a combined way. That means they were doing the answers, means all answers were in a group studies. That was not expected from them. So it is something like if somebody is not observing you, and then it was in a unison answer. So this was a complete failure in that case. Now this situation we can consider in today's online education that children and the staff is taking, peers are taking out. This was complete story what I wanted to share so that we can understand how world will face if we cheat somewhere in between. There will always be a consequences. We will be caught somewhere else. Now I would focus about what are the skills required in 2030 that is labeled by World Economic Forum and McKinsey's. So this is complex problem solving. I will read out the skills which are coming out: critical thinking, creativity, people management and team player, coordination with others, emotional intelligence, judgmental decision making, service orientation, negotiations, and the last one is cognitive flexibility. I will touch base on 1, 2, 3 skill. In Personality Matrix, we have a complete methodology to check a score of each person's by going through certain tests. So they a candidate can be tested how much is a score in each skills out of his thinking pattern and everything. So now I will take about complex problem solving skill. Now, if we consider today's situation, whatever the question we pose, Google is having most of the answers. Now, what if the answer is not available with the Google? So there are the complex problem solving skills are required in this case. A person or a candidate has to think in a different way, and then he has to arrive to the answer which is not expected or not anticipated. The complete course in this case, is there in the market available, where a brain has been trained to how a person can solve a complex problems. Now I will touch base of the thing creativity. Creativity is the skill that mostly evaluated in COVID-19 situation. We arrived with so many creative persons in this complete 1.5 years era. So I will touch base 2 to 3 points in this case. If we see, there was the WhatsApp video gone viral. Teachers are showing their creativity to educate students or to teach the students by hanging mobile phone with somewhere else and sitting in a proper posture so that they can watch their students and follow, complete their task of giving educations. Now, this is one part of the story. Students are also more creative in this case. What I understand means when I discuss with the so many students, I mean, they can relate in these situations. Now the online, taking an online exam itself is the biggest task for the government, teachers and education institutes. So what is happening now, questions, whatever the questions that supposed to come into the syllabus, the students are already writing the answers of them in a certain page and they kept that aside while on in front of the camera. They just pretend that they are writing the answers and then whatever they have been asked to upload, that has getting uploaded. I'm sorry, but I may have opened up the skills of so many students, but that is something that is coming out. Another area is the creativity of the students. Now, if a teacher is observing it and the mic is in a mute mode, but teacher is observing. Now what the students are doing, they are keeping Google or Alexa there sideways. Whatever the question is being asked in examination, they just utter the question, Alexa answers the questions, and the answer is there, which is written on the paper. So this is something creativity has coming out from the student sides. That is, I mean, we should think on it. And that is something very innovative ideas that is coming out from the student communities. Now, when we study about the creativity graph is very high at the student level and it goes on diminishing when we go to the job market and perform certain tasks. If somebody wanted to relate who is doing a corporate job about this creativity, I mean, a boss has said that you should be creative enough to solve the problems. And then they plan a meeting tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock. You all come and show us the ideas of the creativity. Come on, how come an creativity come out in just 1 hour or in a day and everybody will be creative in one time, one place? That is something which needs to be understand and discussed. Rest all the skills that are there mentioned and that can be find out in Google. You can work and understand how these skills can be developed. These are something jobs options about skills which is considered in the future slides. Now, problem solving skills. When we say a problem solving skill, it needs an analytical skills and innovative ideas. So this problem solving skills is much required in the job, whichever jobs we wanted to apply or come out. You need to be come out from the different idea and coming out of the monotony. Industry expects that whatever you are learning from the college education is not that important rather than your problem solving skills. So this is a key area. Second is self-management. Self-management is something which relates to the active learning and learning strategies, resilience, stress management, and flexibility. What we say nowadays, current situation is, a person needs to be in a learning phase always because technology is changing and there is always demand that you need to learn something new. And this for this learning category, so many tools are available online. I mean, anybody can learn anything by sitting at home. Third category is working with people. This completely needs a leadership qualities and emotional intelligence part and social influence. Technology use and development. This is completely for the programmers which needs a development idea. Here, if somebody do not have an emotional skill more, but he is more towards than analytical skill, this part will be the taken care. Now again, when we say about skills, this Albert Einstein says everybody is a genius. This I relate to the students who are in the age of around 16 or 18 and who are planning their career or thinking for their career, and they are thinking that they are not genius or they are not good in something, but they are very good in other things. So this goes to that level. Everybody is genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb tree, it will live its whole life believing that it's stupid. So that is something, if a child of is a student is having certain skills, there needs to be a mechanism that whatever the skills that he have and he is in it, rather than focusing on a job based on that skills he do not have, the focus area should be whatever the skills he has, his job area should be related to that skills. So that is the reason I wanted to I put this slide in this presentation. Now when that is another point comes into the mind about insanity. Now this is for the people who are already in a job with an experience of around 5 to 10 years. What their mindset is, they are doing the same things over and over again. But what Albert Einstein said, do the same thing again and again and expecting a different results. That is called as insanity. So this insanity needs to be developed. This keeps a focus to the job and monotony is avoided in this case. Now, how this can be achieved? There is a certain courses, certain parameters are there where a monotony in a job is being avoided and a person or a candidate finds new avenues to do the same things with finding the different solution. Now we have a framework of about skill upgrade, how we upgrade our skills. So I relate in this case, there are the four baskets. First one is comfort, insecurity, confidence and security. So we need to think on a vertical manner in each bracket. So when we say a comfort, I relate to the person who is in the engineering graduate or somewhere, because I belong to the engineering graduate. So I relate so many things to the students or the persons who are coming to the industry. In this case, whenever a person comes for an interview or comes out from the college, he is very comfortable. He has not seen what a job work will be like this. He has not understood what will be the challenges, concern areas, things that he needs to do in his job. So we consider this as an unconscious incompetence. Unconscious incompetence means he is very comfortable that whatever he know, that is 100% and he is good enough to do his job, and he's on a top of word that I know everything and I will do myself best for the industry and whatever the job I will apply. Now when he goes for the interview, situation two comes in his mind. Some persons got accepted an offer, but there are around 80% who got rejected for certain offer. Now once he got rejected, he has a two situation: go back, analyze himself and find out what are his key areas of the concern. Now in this case, a mind and a brain plays a bigger role. Now he has understood that I do not know certain things. So when he do not know certain things, there is an insecurity comes to his mind and a brain. Now he is into the phase of conscious incompetence. Now he understood that he do not have a complete competency. Now there are two choices. First one, whether he wanted to upgrade his skill or he could go back and be in a comfort zone and write for an opportunity to come based on his comfort zone. Again, the luck parameter plays a bigger role over here. As said, you should be prepared for the opportunities coming in so that you will be ready for a larger picture in the industries coming. Now, after this situation, the mindset in this case would be the confusion and a frustration. I mean, he will have to work hard to acquire the skills which he is missing. Now we come to the third stage. Here, what he has done, he or she has done, he has acquired skills, got the confidence, again attempted for the interview and got job. Now he is confident. The situation now in this case will be the conscious competence. You are able to use the skill, but only with effort. Now you learn the skills, but you need an effort to do that skills. Now you will have to sharpen the skills so that you could get master in it. Now in this case, once he got the confidence, he has the feelings of achievement and excitement to do better. Now the third phase comes where the industry says the persons who are into the experience of around 10 years or something, unconscious competence. Now they feel that skills they have acquired is automatically doing their job. Now whatever the task they have to do, that is coming automatically. For example, if I wanted to say Excel operating skills. Excel operating skills are quite required in today's scenario, or a PowerPoint skills. Initially, it was a tough time taking, but when a candidate or a person takes into the level, his master in it. In this case, it is a security and it is automatic phenomenon in this case. Now, if this person after 10 year experience is wanted to go to the next orbit, again, he has to go through all these four phases and then he has to develop the skills in this case. So this is about a skill upgrade situation and phenomenon. Now, what I'll talk about current situation, who is a students that we are facing. Now, there are three things that is considered in a job market. First is a qualification, that your degree or your paper that you have got from the institute that shows. The second is skills. As of now, we do not have any paper or anything that shows the skills that candidate or a person has. Whatever the written on a resume or a CV, that is considered as whatever he is saying is right, and there is a counter check for it. Now the third skill is a behavior and mindset. This mindset and behavior is studied in a 1 hour interview or a 15 minutes interview a person attends. And based on these three parameters, a person's confidence has been evaluated at the interviewer stage. Now this confidence building mechanism is something, if you have a qualification, skills and behavior mindset, it's an 100 hour practice phenomenon is there. If you perform something in 100 hours, you get the confidence in that particular skills. So there is a framework of how to build the confidence, and the material is available in the market, in the internet for this also. Now, when we say in current situation, there are considered as two phenomenons, that is emotional quotient and intelligent quotient. IQ and EQ, these two are the things that is considered best for getting into the job market. IQ is something like technical know-how, which is required for architecture trade-off, experts in technology, senior architect. I mean, that is critical thinker, that something very knowledgeable things has to do. In this case, IQ, higher IQ persons are very much required. But there is again a phenomena where EQ persons are required. There they need a complete motivation, reflective, self-aware and relationship management, empathetic person. And if I wanted to share something about this, I mean, there are a situation, those persons who are into the corporate job are doing something, they can relate to this. I mean, if a boss is having some task to do, he has certain ways to explain to the his subordinate or juniors. First, he will take, openly that I need to perform this task and this is the deadline. So what subordinates do, they consider they already have certain tasks to do and they manage this task and when they should be done. Now, all of a sudden pressure comes. No. Deadline is there and you need to do this in within 1 day time or 4 hours time. Now, in this case, EQ plays a bigger role. In this case, whosoever is the candidate at the receiving it, he gets demotivated, dejected. He feels embarrassed and he has so many questions that how I will perform this task, which was supposed to be done in 7 days and now required to be done in 4 hours or something like this. So somebody can relate this situation. Now, how someone can handle these situations? So there are the things available, how one can manage a team time management and something like breaking a project from the bigger cake to smaller parts. Defined timeline for each smaller part and what is the takeaway and what could be done immediately and priorities. So these are the things are there which needs to be learned and upgraded. This is again a research says IQ can help you to be successful to the extent of 20% only life. The rest of the 80% success depends on your EQ. Now, EQ is a most important criteria and in current industry or I would say educational qualification, this is not taken into the consideration. I'm not sure whether somewhere it is taking care, but majority of the cases, EQ has not been taught how to develop. Now, again, something comes about if we understand what are the skills required, but again, a phenomena is there, how much time it requires to get something new skills for the job market. So benchmark is considered as a 6 months max. Because if you are not able to learn and master the skills in 6 months, then there's something new will come out considering a pace of the industry going on and speed at which we are functioning in the future. So first 2 months are people, culture, and whatever you wanted to understand. This slide is about cloud computing and for the IT background, how skills are upgraded, but this is more related to the everywhere. And this is derived from World Economic Forum jobs requirements. 2 to 3 months are product development and data skills. 4 to 5 months are something like engineering skills and whatever skills you wanted to learn. But this depends on domain to domain, how you can master their skills accordingly. Now, this is my last slide I will be coming. Now, what is considered in nowadays is we heard about the story about tortoise and a rabbit. In the earlier phenomena, it is said that slow and steady wins the race. But this proverb is changed in 21st century. Now it is considered that slow and steady never qualifies the race, or it is very tough for slow and steady persons to even qualify for the race, because now the changeover time for the things are hardly 1 day or 2 day. Everything, if you can relate anything, is information is flowing in so much pace that anything can change in few minutes time or an hour's time. So that is something that need to be considered and upgraded ourselves. Now we at a Personality Matixx, we do career assessments. There is a systematic way of assessing careers, mid-career mentoring, leadership coaching, and change management. We are a professional of 10 professionals who are from the different industry background who work on it and assess and work on a larger picture of the community so that a bottom line of the community can be upgraded and we as a community take part as per the AMP mission for the upgradation of the community. Now, I would like to give an acknowledgement that Mr. Zade Sayed, who is a business head of Yarn Marketing Department at CRM, who has helped me to compile this presentation, and he has also having a knowledge about team management and everything, and we compiled the presentation based on his inputs. Second one is Ms. Wahida Sheikh. She is an employee within Siemens, about 20 years of work experience and working in resource manager department. She has a complete knowledge of handling different teams in different domain. She is working with overseas customers, and her knowledge has helped me a lot, and I wanted to thank her as well. Third one is Ms. Afreen Sayed. She has an own startup of well engineering based in Nerul, and she is performing her duties as an automation engineer. She has around 18 years of experience, and she is by qualification an instrumentation engineer. Again, I would like to thank Association of Muslim Professionals for giving me an opportunity so that whatever the knowledge I have, I am able to share to the upliftment of the community. If around 20% or 10% of it is a benefited and could work on something, so I will think that my purpose is served and I participated in the larger goal of the community development. So in this case, I would like to stop my presentation. I thank you all. And I thank AMP team Heba, who coordinated with me for this presentation, complete AMP team. And whenever I will be required in a future or a team, so I am always there for the support and development to the community. So that's all from my side. If any questions are there, we can take the questions. And over to you, Heba.
Thank you so much, Mr. Atik. That was a very knowledgeable session. I would request all the attendees to put across their question if they have. Before doing that, I would like to quickly summarize what Mr. Atik has covered. Moving right from the start, where he has started the journey from 1901 to 2000, the 21st century, what all technology shift that has happened across the world and what all innovation has happened. He spoke about the latest 21st century innovation, like 3D printing, blockchain, capsule endoscopy, and many more. He has also touched based on automation, digitization, nutrition, apparel and life play from home, luxury products. Moving ahead, he has also spoken about the emerging jobs which the students need to focus on, and the 10 declining jobs which will be more handled or which will get automated. The declining jobs were some of the declining jobs were data entry clerks, accounting, bookkeeping, administrative process, whereas the emerging jobs are the data analyst, AI and machine learning, digital transformation specialist, and many more. He emphasized on the skills and what exactly is a skill and how important it is to develop the skills. He has focused on the 12 jobs, which will be very essential and for which people needs to prepare, like the organ creator, the augmented reality journal builder, trash engineer, and many more. He has spoken about the skills which are required in 2030, the skills like complex problem solving, critical thinking, creativity, people management. He has also spoken about how an upgrade of skill happens and how important it is to go through each and every phases. And he has emphasized on the importance of the IQ and EQ, how these things plays role in your skill upgrade. And the very important point that he has also mentioned, that not everybody is the same and not everybody can be judged or defined or have a same kind of skill set. It's important to identify your IQ and EQ and upgrade yourself accordingly. He has also gone through the timelines that would be required for different kinds of skill upgradation. He has spoken about the mentoring skill upgrade mentorings that happens within Personality Matixx. With this, I would like to thank Mr. Atik for this session, which was very enlightening. Moving ahead, I have few Q&A and I would like to take that. So we have few Q&As on the Zoom. I would like to take that first. The very first question is from one of the participants, and he asks, Sir, I have just taken admission in IIM Sirmaur. It was great hearing you. How should I spend my next 2 years? Also, what all certifications are recommended during this tenure as I am a fresher? My UG is B.Tech in Pharma.
Okay, so for answering these questions, what I would like to say, first, Mr. Abdul Rafe Saeed, you have to understand what is your key area of interest. I mean, where you are more passionate about doing work. Maybe it is biotechnology. I don't know much about the pharma, but your seniors or your peers must be knowing. You must be having certain subjects which are there in a syllabus. So in whichever areas you feel that I am more interested. Now, area of interest is taken care. Now, based on that, you understand what are the industry players or job opportunities related to that area of interest and go on upgrading the knowledge, skills, based on that area. So what this will help us, this will give an edge over others in your expertise, and you will be stand out in your understanding and things what you plan yourself for the future. Hope I am answered it. I have answered it properly.
Thank you, Mr. Atik Sheikh. I would like to take the next question now. So since you talked about cryptocurrency, we have a question regarding that. First is, like, we know that cryptocurrency is on a boom and it's growing and everything, but we want to understand, like, what all are the career opportunities around the cryptocurrency? What is your point of view around that?
See, currently, if we consider it as a cryptocurrency, the boom is considered in terms of trading, because it is being highlighted by Elon Musk. One tweet of Elon Musk, deviates a cryptocurrency from this point to another point. Now, understanding a cryptocurrency, how it is developed, there is a different area of a market which is untapped yet. It needs to be again think differently in how this cryptocurrency is developed. What I understand about is a deep machine learning programming is there, that is called as deep mining and everything. So this is again an area if somebody wants to go into the mining of the cryptocurrency. Now, if he wanted to go about management of cryptocurrency, this area is still undeveloped. But there are the potentials. The peoples in US are working on it. In today's economic times, I just read today, US is having a maximum ATM machines for cryptocurrency. Now, again, how these ATM machines are developed for the cryptocurrency? The phenomena is somebody has to put a US dollars and he gets the cryptocurrency out of it rather than any block any account of a trader account, something. So these are the things that somebody has to think and develop accordingly. Hello.
Thank you. I would like to take the next question, which is on the 3D printing. So you spoke about 3D printing and it's asked, how can we start 3D printing? What will be the investment to start and training institute to learn the same?
I am not expert about answering this question because I basically discusses about the development on a skills and career opportunities. But yes, if you wanted to know about more about 3D printing, a lot of technological developments are going on in Dubai and UAE. There are the institutes that they are offering 3D printing courses, and investment is already there. So I may not be give exact number about the investment for the 3D printing technology, but yes, it saves a lot of construction time and whatever the machine parts required for the automobile industries that are taking care in this case.
Thank you. Going ahead with the next question, it's a very interesting question. It's asked, during the pandemic times, networking and interpersonal development skills are not easily acquirable. Due to lack of meeting diverse people, how should one go about developing their soft skills during pandemic times?
Yeah, actually, this is a very interesting question. And I mean, I answered this question with earlier forums as well, because now based on the COVID situations, area of concern to the brain is very high. I mean, there are so many things people do not know how it will come out. And alternate day, we are finding so many newses are there. So there is an uncertainty in the whole atmosphere, whole climate. Now, developing about the social skills. In the earlier stages, we were talking face to face. Now, there are the devices. This seems some vague, but now the communication of a family as well is going on a Google Meet or something called Zoom. So this is something, a community has to adopt to the time frame, plan a complete Google Meet of a say 10 members who are into the different locations, have some chats, and then discuss about it. So lighten the mood in this case, because considering the current situation and the future phenomenon, this seems like difficult to have a face-to-face and one-on-one conversation with a distance less than 1 meter. So, I mean, we need to adopt this change and develop ourselves socially accordingly. That's what my takeaway in this case, because this is a tricky question. I mean, something very difficult.
Thank you. Going ahead with the next question. So the next question is, what specific skills should a first year degree student acquire in order to prepare for these jobs? So by these jobs, I guess it meant like, you know, the latest jobs that you were talking about, like the organ creator and the other jobs that you have spoken about.
Yes. So in this case, again, it comes to the area of interest. Now, how this area of interest is defined? So I consider current situation, when we say our area of interest is defined when we passed out the 10th standard. If somebody is passed out a 10th standard with a very good academics, it is considered that he will go to the science, although he will be having a very good skills in arts or something. It's a general phenomena. But if his area of interest is something called as a music, there is a good career in music. If his area of interest is creativity, so there is another career available in creativity. But based on this situation, he has to go through a process of engineering and something. So based on his skills, he finds an alternate career clubbed with these skills. Now, coming back to the question, I would say you analyze yourself first. What is, based on the subject line you are studying, which are your area of interest? For example, if you are very good in a mathematics, you has a certain analytical and problem solving skills. And if you are very good in statistics, I would say, this big data analytics and this data scientist is a quite good requirement in near future. If you are very good in creative, that means you find an alternate solution for a same problem. There are so many careers available for a creative persons. So it depends upon the area of interest. Now there are studies how to find an area of interest, because this is again a dynamic. Some persons today feels that my area of interest is say mathematics, but once he do some tasks and it is difficult to perform that task, he feel bored and he feels no, now today I do not have a interest in mathematics. So this happens. So this is a dynamic stage of a life and a brain. So it needs to be considered in between where someone stands, and based on that, he has to think and derive his career.
Thank you. We have another interesting question, which is, since we are talking about the careers opportunities in the future. So the question says, what is beyond Google? They have everything with them in technology advancement. Will anyone break their monopoly? And how should the today's generation should get ready for that?
Yes, there will be the someone. Because yesterday I've seen a presentation of ISB. I mean, they have a good study about how Google is arrived. So to answer this question, we'll have to go back. Somebody is studying how Google is arrived. And something will come out where something will come out, then there will be a monotony of Google maybe break. Now, if we go this way, Google is firstly a search engine and their major revenue is from the advertisings. Now, what Google does, they do not charge for the one person who is using their platform, but the charges are very high at the another side. What happens, European concerns, they do not want this, that their privacy is, privacy and whatever the information Google is taking should not be shared to the another one. Now there is another search engines are coming into the market. I would say DuckDuckGo is the one of the them that I understand sometimes 1.5 years back, because they do not track whatever the information is there. So now there is a area of concern in the community that whatever the information is there, everything is tracked. So something will come out in a society that my information should not get tracked. And then some player will come and monopoly of Google may or may not will break. That is just a takeaway from my side. I don't know. I mean, it would come out in a future or somebody is working on it. That is something, again, an area of discussion, an area of concern, something a future generation can work on it.
Thank you. Going ahead with the next question. As a student perspective, how a student can acquire skills like being a team player or managing a team or problem solving, critical thinking, the skills that you have mentioned?
A team player is a very easy skill. If somebody is playing a football or any game, a team player skill is inbuilt in a human brain. The only point is he should learn how he understand the conflict, and whenever some problem comes or some fight comes, he should analyze how he handled that thing, whether he got depressed or he handled it properly. He has made an alignment with all the peer persons, and that way the team player skill is get developed from the initial stages, and it goes on increasing. And in terms of problem solving skills, there are the things available in a market which trains themselves how to solve a problem. I will say a simple example. I mean, Sudoku comes to the newspapers, and normal time frame to solve a Sudoku is around, I would say, a normal person will try, it will take almost 4 or 5 hours to solve it. But now it is people are there who solve in less than 3 minutes. Another one is that what I can say that that six magic ball and that magic ball and something that they solves. I do not recollect the name. They solves in and the international record is there. They solve that puzzle in a 3 minutes. That there are the colors on each side. Six colors are there and it's Rubik cubes. So it needs to be solved in a certain time frame. So these skills are there which develops a brain to solve complex problems or DAO problem solving skills. I hope I answered this question.
All right, thank you. Moving ahead, we have a next question. As someone in a start of his career, how we can create a social influence?
See, we as a community, whatever we have knowledge and information, giving back to the society is the point which gives a social connections. If somebody is planning for an engineering or a medical, he take out some time and mentor somewhere who is in the 12th grade or who is trying to prepare himself for the studies he has already taken. So this way he can develop a social connect and plan himself or herself to build the community. That is one part of it. Another one is whatever the ideas he has, he can share the same to his peers, or there are the platforms available on the internet like a content writing. If he's too good about it, he can write, continue his skills, upgrade in a Google or a YouTube channels are there. That is another way of looking into it. So this way, there will be a library and everything he will get into it.
Thank you. We have another question which asks, what are the platforms where or what are the organization who conducts the IQ and EQ test so that I can decide on my skill sets or I can work along my skill sets?
If you Google, there are so many things, so many institutes are there. Even we at the Personality Matixx conduct IQ and EQ test. I mean, that is, I will say something earlier before COVID situations, we were going to the workshops of engineering final year students or in the industries there, we are waking a person who immediately enters to the job market, a questionnaire has been given to him. Now, this is something different from the psychometry test. Then he has to attempt the certain question. There are the 20 questions, but while attempting his questions, there is a person from a team who observes his situations while he's answering the questions. The questions are like a decision making and different skills, how he arrives to the decision and skill based questions. Post that, his handwriting is also analyzed by the experts who are sitting over there. Then he has given a time frame. He can go back. This answer sheet has been collected with the invigilator. They study these answers. Then out of a moon, the team says, you will get a call from the team randomly where you will have to answer certain questions that are the random ones so that the candidate should be ready to answer instantly and how his brain reacts instantly to the sudden questions come out. This is only to test whatever the feedback he has given at the time of answering and the feedback on a call, whether it is matches or not. Based on these answers, a map is derived, complete skill set is derived, and then outcome is arrived what skills he has. Post that, he has been interviewed with the person who has analyzed his skill set and he explains everything about him, because it is very difficult for a candidate, for a person to read whatever written over there. So this is something, there are so many platforms are available who can develop this phenomena. I mean, if somebody wants to have more knowledge about it, they can write it to us, our team can guide, or they can Google it. That's it from my side. I mean, I answered this question. If anything else, Siba?
Thank you. I guess we have other questions too, which has come up now. So someone is asking, what are the top trends for lawyers in emerging markets?
What I understand about the trend of the lawyers in this case, because of the data available and the big data, now everybody, whatever the case is there, there are the record, what was the history of that case, and that will be available in a domain. Yes, in terms of lawyer, there is a higher studies are required, because there will be the more crimes anticipated in terms of cyber security, cyber threats, and forensics. So in this area, there is a very good scope for the lawyers to explore their careers for the future. That's what my study says in this case.
Thank you. We have another question which is not relevant to the topic, so I'm going to ignore that topic. Thank you so much. I guess that was all the question we had. I would like Mr. Kashif Bhai to take over the session now.
Yeah, thank you, Siba. Jazakallah khair, Mr. Atik Sheikh, for a brief and elaborate session today. I would like to thank you for today's session. I would like to thank all the participants who had participated and posted the questions. Thank to Atik Bhai again for answering the questions patiently. Thank AMP for arranging today's web talk for the upliftment of the community. And I would like to thank all the volunteers who are working behind the scene to arranging this type of web talks and series and all. Jazakallahu khair. Now.